that we made over here from ChatGPT, brought it over here to Google Sheets, and now we're bringing it over here into Canva, and now it's going to generate 31 pages for us, which is going to be really awesome. So we're going to hit generate.
How to bulk create social media posts with Canva and ChatGPT. Before we get into the content, make sure you guys give this video a thumbs up.
Three things that we're gonna be using in this video is a Google Sheets, or you can use Excel. And the goal is to download it in a CSV file at the end. So if you can think of any other type of software that can do that for you, by all means do it. Next is Canva. Canva has a 7 or 14 day free trial. The link's gonna be down below in the description, so check that out. All right, so this is ChatGPT, and then what we're gonna be focusing on is the send a message part right here on the bottom. See where I clicked? This right here, when it comes to using ChatGPT, you wanna think about it like as a, it's like a writing assistant, so it's gonna help. And this is really cool because you can write ideas, different ideas in here, and it will help you populate different ideas, which is really, really awesome. You're gonna see how this works. And if you haven't signed up for it, go sign up for it, and you haven't messed with it, it's free. I recommend test it out. Pretty much learn it every single day until you get a better understanding of how it can help you with your business, right? So write me, let's say, 30 motivational quotes with author under 100 characters. Arrange in a table. Now, this right here. So this can be like, you can switch this out. Yoga, right? Yoga. Whatever niche you're in, baseball, basketball, you know, whatever it is, whatever niche that you're in, you can switch it out. But for this example, we're going to go ahead and use motivational quotes with author under 100 characters arranged in a table. And then, like, so for example, you can put like just two sentences, one sentence, three sentences. It's that simple. And then we're arranging it in a table to kind of help us number it. So we're gonna go ahead and hit enter, and then we copy and paste it over into your Excel or your spreadsheet or Google Sheets. It makes it easier for us to copy and paste it over there. So we're gonna go ahead and hit send, and you can see how it's making it. And sometimes another thing, like the author, it won't pop up. Like if you don't wanna put author, you just wanna just put it, just take out the author, set it with author, just leave that part out. It will, you know, it'll populate, but sometimes it won't have an author, and you can just put like unknown or something like that. I know you've seen like posts like on Instagram, Facebook, or any of those platforms, right? Or even TikTok, you'll see it'll say like unknown, and that's what it is. But if you're generating, you know, quotes or something like that from a famous person, you want to make sure that you're giving them a shout out. And I'm going to show an example right now. All right, so what we're going to do is go ahead and just highlight, you know, everything here on this page, all the quotes and stuff, and bring it over here to your Google Sheets. Make sure you name it. I have it at social media posts. I'm just gonna go ahead and just hit Control V, or you can just come over here to edit and paste, or you can just right click and paste, right? And then it's real simple. Just kind of like open up the, you see how I, right here on the columns, I just move this a little bit and it'll extend a little bit more. So you can see like what the quotes look like, and just do it as until all the quotes fit in there exactly how you want them to fit, or however you think, right? It's good right there, right? It looks good right there. So we have this right here. We're good. So we have 31. And we have 31 quotes, it looks like, right? 32 right here, but with one, this one being the actual header and the quote. So quote and author. So we're making sure that you understand that you have it exactly the way that I have it. So we're gonna go ahead, and so we have the quote and author, and what we're gonna do is gonna go ahead and file, and we're gonna go ahead and go to download, and then you're gonna hit CSV, comma separated values. So you wanna make sure you download it in the CSV format. Boom, that's gonna download. It's gonna download to the PC. And then what we're gonna do is come over here to Canva. And I have the Pro, and like I said, this is gonna be down below in the description. If you guys want to test out the trial, they have a free trial. And then obviously after that, you would have to pay. I think I pay like, I'm not even sure. I think it's like $11.99 a month, something cheap like that, right? Now, depending on the post that you want to create, right? Let's say for Instagram, we want to do an Instagram post, and you can do, this is just search bar. You can just do anything. You can just type in like Facebook, right? And then it'll give you like different, you know, templates for all of that. I use this pretty much every day. So if you want to do Instagram, whatever that you want to do. So come over here. I'm gonna go just do the square post. Now, this is the cool thing too. So we have the CSV downloaded already, right? We're gonna use this right here, bulk create. As I come over here into bulk create, we're gonna go ahead and upload the CSV right here. Now you can enter data manually, but we already have the CSV. So what we're gonna do is upload that CSV. So social media post sheet one right there. And then I'm gonna go ahead and hit upload. Now it's gonna, based off of the data that we have, right, what we downloaded. Now we have, you know, everything that we're kind of going off of this. This is like our, you know, our little bookmark. So the quote and author. And then if we come over here to Canva, you're gonna see quote, author. You see Roosevelt, Steve Jobs, right? And it's getting it. It's basically reading from here, right? What we download onto the computer, we upload it over there, and it's reading it from there. So stick along with me. Now, next is like, it says right click on the element in your page to connect it to your data below. Okay, so we're not done. This is a very important step, so make sure you understand it. Now, elements, you know, there's different things that can be done in here. So as far as like the elements, let's say like a photo, like you want to search for like a like something like a tiger, you know, you got some tiger stuff. There's different elements that you can search for in here. Lion, lion's like a big thing, right? Look at the lion, king of the jungle, right? So you can put like a lion face in there if you want to do something like that, right? Make something like motivational, right? Roar, you know, something like that. You can do something like that. Or if you have your branding, right? And for this example, I already have an example. You can upload anything on the back end over here. So let's say I'm going to use this. This is my branding, my image. Ooh, I am going to go ahead and, yeah, make that out. And then let's say I just want to keep something, to keep it very simple, right? I'm going to put in like the left-hand corner. You can see how I'm moving around, right? Left-hand corner on the side, I just want to put it black, right? Right there, boom. And then I'm going to go in here, the text, right? I'm going to go ahead and add some text in here. So let's say we want, this is going to be the quote, and this is important, guys. So the quote, and then you can adjust any of this. You're seeing how I'm just kind of going to the corners and just stretching it, right? You can adjust any of this stuff. You can change the, and I'm going to show you right now, you can change the size of the font. Let's say that's too big. Right, I wanted to put it to 80, and then I can change, like, you know, it has the font, it has all kinds of different recommended fonts that, you know, it's telling me to use. There's tons in here that you can use. So I can scroll down on the left hand side, there's a ton of different font. You can even search it to the way the font that you want, you can search it right there. So let's say I want it there, and then I'm come back over here, and then I'm at another one, and this is going to be the author. And I want this to be smaller, right? Smaller, obviously spell it right too. And a lot of big brand pages, you'll see them do this type of stuff. So keep that in mind. Maybe that's, this is a personal preference too, the way that you want to do it. You can, however, if you want to make it a little bit bigger, you can do that. You're suggesting it to how you're liking, right? And I can just bring this down a lot, down here a little bit. And you can see that it's a, with my logo kind of matching up a little bit right there. That's where you want it to be kind of centered. And then if I want to make it a little bit more bigger, let's say I want to make it bigger, you can do that. But let me go ahead and making sure that we get it in there correct. Let's do the 88K. This one's lined up correctly. Boom. Now we got everything right there. Now we're going to go ahead and right click, because let's come back over here. It says right here, right click. So we're going to right click, connect data. And this is going to be the quote. And then this one's going to be the author. Right now, it's given, it's highlighting the bar that we can click on the continue button on the left hand corner, right? As we hit continue, basically pulling everything up that we had in our CSV file, right? Basically everything that we have over here that we made over here from ChatGPT, brought it over here to Google Sheets, and now we're bringing it over here into Canva. And now it's going to generate 31 pages for us, which is going to be really awesome. So we're going to hit generate. Or you can also too, just if you want, there's something that you don't like, you can unhighlight it, you know, unselect, select all, and generate. And now here's where the magic happened. All right, this is cool. So this is page one, page two, and obviously it's something like this, like a little bit, like a quote like this will probably be, and it's real simple to edit too, right? You see how I did that? Some of the quotes are longer than, you know, others. So there's gonna be some editing that needs to be involved, and there's nothing wrong with that, because it's real simple to do. You can see that, right? Boom, it's something like this, all right? And so you wanna just make that a little smaller, you can do that, and then keep it going, and just basically edit this whole thing. And this is gonna be a personal preference too, so if there's, you know, you don't like it the way, you know, it's doing it, you can edit on your end the way that you want it to be. Maybe, you know, the font's a little bit too big for you, and you want it a little smaller, or, you know, because we're on page 15, halfway there. And this is why, you know, I put a cap on the characters in each quote as best as, you know, try to do it as best as possible. But then you can also, you know, you can also make the font smaller. Boom. All right, now let's look at the view. Look at, so we got basically 31 posts. Click on that one real fast. I mean, that one's, so we got 31 posts. That's 31 days of posting, right? Or whatever you post every other day or every 3 days or once, one quote a week. We literally just scheduled out all the posts. It says, say you're building your brand page and you have your theme page on Instagram. This is one way that you can use this and build out a branded page of, and grow a following and grow a brand on any social media platform. Okay, so keep this in mind and how you can use it for your business. And this is very, very powerful, which is really, really awesome, because it just saved you so much time, and you can see how fast we did it, right? Which is amazing. So there it is right there, you know, as far as getting your post out using Canva.
And if you'd like to learn more about AI tools, watch this video right here.